This is a town that people need to and love to come to. I read different things all the time about, I visited Wellsboro and I was surprised, or I was really pleased at what this community has to offer. And we want to be part of that. When we build the greater museum, it'll be to share the history and another thing that you can do when you come into the town of Wellsboro.
Hello and welcome to the Homepage Network. I'm Sarah Vogt. On this beautiful day in Pennsylvania, I'm with Skip Cavanaugh, and we affectionately call him the Glass Historian. Skip, what's going to be in this pop-up store behind us?
Well, thank you for having me, Sarah. We have a group of people here in Wellsboro getting incorporation, and we're going to have a 501c3 nonprofit designation. And for awareness in the community, we wanted to start a pop-up museum. And so Mr. Ben Stanbaugh, who owns this property behind us, graciously allowed us to move in here for a period of time, which we don't know, and to have a pop-up museum. And we'll be displaying some of the products, some of the pictures, and a lot of the history of the Wellsboro glass plant on 1 Jackson Street, Wellsboro.
This is a beautiful town to come and see the beautiful area that we live in. So when they come to this pop-up store that's kind of a precursor to the museum, what would they see?
Well, we have many shapes and sizes of different products that we made here in many different color schemes, from bug yellow to soft pink, and reasons for different colors that we did in ceramic. We have frosted product that we inside frosted using hydrofluoric acid, and many shapes, photo cubes, flash cubes. We had a whole line of photo flash products that we made. We made tumblers, we made votive cups, and floor tile.
So Skip, why is it so important to remember this glass history?
Well, history of glass bulb making started in 1916 with Corning Glass, and they owned that factory for 65 years. If you lived in Wellsboro, you knew somebody or had a relative from a father, grandfather, aunt, uncle, somebody worked at the Corning Glass Works to produce glass. And then in 1939, during the blockade, just prior to the war, when we got involved, you couldn't buy products from Germany or France because they had a blockade on the ocean. And we started making Christmas tree ornaments for Shiny Bright, Max Eckerd, and George Frankie, and different ones. And we became the Christmas tree ornament capital of the world in downtown Wellsboro. So it was an exciting time, and a lot of history about glass making and how the factory at 1 Jackson Street contributed and promoted this town of Wellsboro. And it all started with the brand new Chamber of Commerce that said, we want something in that factory in downtown Wellsboro, and they actively went to Corning and secured that business. And it stayed here from 1916 through 2016, with the actual closing a year later in 17.
So much information, so much history. That's why you're called the Glass Historian. So when can they come to this pop-up store?
Friday of Memorial Weekend, we're going to be open for a few hours in the afternoon. We'll be open all day Saturday from 10 o'clock in the morning until 5 o'clock in the evening. And we'll be open on Sunday, same hours. and somewhat on Monday, Memorial Day. But we don't want to take away from any of the Memorial Day activities up at the cemetery or the American Legion or any of those kind of things. We don't want to interfere with that because we are veterans. Corning Glass, GTE, those companies supported their veterans, and we had a few that went to World War II that did not return. So we honor those people as well as the companies honored them as they served their country. This is a town that people need to and love to come to. I read different things all the time about, I visited Wellsboro and I was surprised, or I was really pleased at what this community has to offer. And we want to be part of that. When we build a greater museum, it'll be to share the history and another thing that you can do when you come into the town of Wellsboro.
As Skip just said, it's one more opportunity to visit the history of the area. Thanks for joining us today on the Homepage Network.
Give someone a smile. Akiko's Floral Arts, helping you give smiles one flower at a time.